Welcome to FOBH. I am Adebayo Omolade, your host for today's show. Today we'll be discussing an important and controversial issue, maintenance culture in public service. And I have some amazing speakers who will be joining me in discussing the topic today. Join me in welcoming Opkoa Sylvia Ijeoma from the Department of Broadcast. And also I have here with me Tela Azizat from Public Relations and Advertisement. Thank you for coming, ma'am. And I have here with me Oladimeji Aziz. Thank you very much for coming, sir. Sylvia, you're looking good.
Thank you.
Tela, you're not bad yourself.
Thank you.
And sir, thank you very much for coming.
You're like, welcome, Ladi.
The current situation of the country is not affecting you guys.
We are facing it.
Thank you. Now back to the discussion of today, public maintenance culture in public service. This is what is affecting almost everybody in the country, both the government and the public. Everybody is a civil servant in one way or the other. So, Sylvia, I'm going to start with you. What do you understand by public service?
Okay, public service is the service rendered by the government
in its jurisdiction through the public sector or through financing private businesses.
All right, thank you, ma'am. Do you have anything to say?
Yeah. Public service are services given by the government to the people. Examples are road, electricity, public schools, public toilets.
Okay. Infrastructure provided by the government to the public. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, do you have anything contradictory to what you just said?
No.
Okay, in that aspect, I'm going to ask you, please, what is maintenance culture?
Maintenance culture in public service. Firstly, I will have to break it down for them to understand easier. Maintenance culture in public service. Maintenance culture is the way and manner in which an individual or an organization maintains the facilities and the personnel that they use for their service. So maintenance culture for public service is the way the public servant maintains their personnel and their facilities.
All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Now let's go out there. Let's see what people out there have to say concerning the topic of the shortly.
Me and I'm here today on the streets to ask people on their opinion on maintenance culture in public service.
I think it's really an aspect. The teachers are not doing the greater job that we expect them to, due to the fact that their own service too at the government side, or if they are not being funded well, I guess, by the government. So them teaching the students well, or even in the university levels, can't be as expected. It can't be good. I think
what's your opinion on maintenance culture in public relations?
We are looking at the police department or police sector. The thing is, I really don't buy into this thing of I don't really think Nigerian police, I don't think they're doing a great job, because the things like profile young youths, and you know, based on their looks, based on the way they're dressed, and all kinds of stuff, which is quite demeaning. Does not make any sense to me. So at that area, I think they are really doing a bad job.
Welcome back. Now we know what people out there have to say concerning the topic. Back to my speakers. Thank you for coming here. Still looking good. Please, Sylvia. The maintenance culture, let's bring it back to our country in Nigeria. What is it like? Is it good? Is it bad?
The maintenance culture in Nigeria is very bad with grave consequences.
Oh my God,
It's something everyone can relate to. The maintenance culture is very poor. Even a child relates to how bad Nigeria's maintenance culture is.
Do you think it's that bad?
Yeah.
Yes, I don't think it's that so bad. Because if we are to look at it on the government aspect, like in Nigeria now, to forget other states, if you look at how Governor Babatunde Fashola does it, he does his end result for his work. He makes sure that the resources he gives his workers, that they make use of it in the most appropriate manner. So that means that even if he's able to do it, other governors of other states should be able to do
it. Okay, that's a kudos to Babatunde Fashola.
Yes, we should say something like that.
In other states, the maintenance culture is very, very bad.
Wow.
I remember traveling to Ibadan like a few days ago. Like it was looking unkempt. And I know some government officials passing through that road without doing anything. That was very bad. So I feel, the maintenance culture in Nigeria is very, very,
I hope you went for a massage.
Yeah, sure. She needs that.
I've been there before. It's
very bad.
I think the government are hearing, and I think they are working on that. Now we want to go on a short break. Welcome back. Back to what we were saying. You all are talking about the government and the government. Do you think the public has a role to play?
No, the government has a higher role to play in something like this. I can remember back then when we had good leaders, like during the military like regime. We had PWD, the Public Workers Department. Those people will stay at every end of the road. They assign people to each part of the road. So if there's a pothole, a little hole, they will quickly fill it up before it expands. So with that, the roads can be maintained, and it's not the public that has anything to do with that.
Me, I feel the public also have a role to play, because there are some things provided by the government that some people are spoiling. So they have to maintain the little things the government are providing.
Thank you very much. So please, how do you think the government and the public can improve on maintaining the public service provided?
I think the first thing they need to do is to teach the people how to make use of those facilities itself. I remember a train station that was built in Ogun State. The Chinese that built the train station, they managed and maintained that train station for 5 years.
5 good years?
Yes, and just a year after they left, the Nigerians that were maintaining that facility, after a year, the facility was destroyed. Like,
so
that train station was destroyed.
Are you saying Nigerians, we can't maintain?
No, we need to be taught how to maintain.
To add to what he said, I feel the government should make public service a course in all levels of education, both primary, secondary, and higher education.
That's even a better idea.
All right, thank you very much. Our government, they are hearing you. I think they are going to improve on that. Sylvia, please, what do you have to say to the government or to the public?
Okay. To the government, or just like to just make it plain, natural. I think they should appoint workers just as they did in the past.
Abasha.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah. They should appoint them to stay at different like lengths of the road, like from year to year, this person will stay this day, this one will stay the next day, different days, and then
all
change
right,
like
thank
that.
Thank you very much, sir.
Aziza. I'll urge the people to maintain the little things the government have provided, because things are now
people are hearing you, sir, please, you have anything to say to the government?
I'll just take from what both of them said, that it is both the government and the people that have to work together to be able to make the country a better place for each and every one of us.
Thank you very much, sir. It's really nice to have you on the show.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
We have all the entire IFTB Motor, so a very big thank you to you. You guys are looking great. Thank you. We love you.
We also thank you.
And to our amazing viewers, we love you. We saw your tweet, like. We want to say a very big thank you to you. Without you, we are nothing. Continue to like, follow us, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time. Same day, same channel. We love you all. Bye. Yeah.